नमस्ते ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, स्टूडेंट्स, स्कॉलर्स, स्पोर्ट्समैन, ट्रेनर्स एंड टीचर्स, प्रोफेशंस, प्रोफेशनल्स एंड प्रोफेसर्स, एडवोकेट्स, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर्स, advertisers, presence of doctors and ministers, reverend fathers and mothers, affectionate sons and daughters, the most respectful present prime minister and Dr. Narendra Modi ji, I Dr. Akesh from USA, heartily, cordially welcome all of you. Those who belong to the field of science, religion, spirituality, arts, commerce, and engineering. Today, now it is really very nice time, nice place, nice section. And we are listening the words of God, which provide us the truth of science and spirituality. It is nice time, nice place, nice section of listening with 100% present sense of mind. Really God's grace and His blessings on us that give us, that provide us, that help us in all the fields of spirituality. As in the history we study that our land is the land of initiators, beginners and starters of the different missions, religions, customs and cultures. It is really recordable and historical that our land is known as, especially in the form of unity and diversity. Our present Prime Minister Sri Dr. Narendra Modi ji went all over the world and addressed the whole world that we Indians, those who are residing in the different nations of the world, whether they are residing in Canada, USA, the America, New Zealand, and in the different nations of the world, basically they belong to the land of India, and their five elements of the body, air, fire, soil, sky and water, basically consumed from the land of India. So this message was spreaded out by Swami Vivekananda in 1893. When Swamiji went in Chicago, he addressed them, "My culture, my custom, and the character of my nation is really matchless, incomparable, and it is unparalleled in all the history, in all the different subjects of study." Swamiji addressed at that time, returned to the Vedas, the Ramayana, the Mahabharata, which is the ancient and traditional part of our holy scripture. Swamiji proved that my nation is known as the nation of gurus, and he proved that, appealed that my nation is the strong believer, ardent believer of the unread, unspoken, unheard, unlistened. So, brothers and sisters, those who are listening, they can know the value of our nation. The persons, those who are needy, rejected, dejected and downtrodden of our society, they must have proud on the sayings and the words, thoughts that was predicted by Swamiji. Everyone knows that there are so many religions in India, but the starters, beginners and initiators of the religions are really recordable, remarkable and outstanding. As Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, who was the founder of Sikhism, who came on this land in 1469, at the same time, William Shakespeare, who was the founder of dramas, born in England in 1564. So this century, which is known as Elizabethan Age in English literature, there are so many similarities of this age, where the teachings of the different religions were the same. And at the same time, in the same century, in 1498, Vasco da Gama discovered India. So, gentlemen, ladies and brothers, those who are listening from the field of education, health and security, they must know the moral, spiritual, social, political, economical values of our nation. Our nation make us able to realize the past. We are known by the presence of mind. If we don't have the presence of free thinkers, philosophers, messengers of this land, but their words, thoughts are immortal and unperishable. We should not forget this thing. On this land, in this country, outsiders come, foreigners visit this land for getting the spiritual attachment. So, it's the man's duty. We should not forget that we are inborn free and we should enjoy the freedom of our nation. Our India got freedom in 1947. A number of freedom fighters sacrificed themselves for the peace of mind and pleasure of tranquility of our heart. It is written in all the holy scriptures basically. In the Hindu mythology, we study the holy Bhagavad Gita. Mohammedans study the Holy Quran, and Sikh people study the Guru Granth Sahib. Christians study the Holy Bible. All the scriptures basically, fundamentally, because of their teachings are the same. So man should understand that the words that are given, that are provided at the different religious places, that is also the form of God in the form of sound and light. This was the great lesson which was given by Swami Vivekananda to the foreigners. We believe the existence of God where there is no light, where there is no sound. Even lightless and soundless position is also the form of God. Swamiji's words are true in the sky, on the earth, in the ocean, in our past, in present and in future. Who he was, who he is, and who he will. In past, present and future, he is the same. So, presence of God is immemorial. We cannot confine in any religious place. If we are true by heart and mind, then our body becomes the temple of God. It is rightly said in the Holy Bible, our body is the temple of God and heart is the seat of God. But when someone will try to research on our human body for the true research of soul, then he will feel that the man's true aim is to unite the soul with super spiritual power of God, who is always with us, even where there is no air, no fire, no soil, no sky and no water. He has the presence also there. In the form of words, we can recollect, regenerate, reform, reoperate. So, all the ministers and doctors also know this thing, that he always live with us in the form of feelings, passions, emotions. Our heart is the seat of God, but not the mind of man. Mind helps only in verifying, improving and in creating WH family words, and creates if and buts. But it is only the heart that helps the soul in keeping us in touch with super spiritual power of God. Gentlemen, if someone wants to get success in his life, then there must be the strong attachment of our mind and heart in presence of the lungs. This is the true aim of our life, to attain, to obtain the salvation and emancipation while residing in this materialistic world. Our materialistic world is not for long time, it's temporary, but the spiritual world is permanent. That is, that was, and that will. So it's man's duty, first duty, to remember the Lord who helped us, created us, founded us in the form of human being. It is written in the whole Holy Scriptures that God created himself in the form of light and sound. Later on, he created 84 lakh species, and this light and sound generated, activated and vibrated the 84 lakh species by the ray of light and by the waves of sound. So the word came in form of existence. It is written in the whole holy scriptures of our Indian religions. So believers, devotees and followers of the different religions must think that it is their first duty. What Swami Vivekananda addressed us in his youth, that power is the name of life and weakness, drawbacks, shortcomings, faults is the name of death. Swamiji further explained that success means not the destination, success means continuity and regularity. When somebody unrelentingly, unceasingly and unstoppingly go on his path to do better, nicer, finer for our society and nation, then definitely his drawbacks, his shortcomings become his achievements. History is evident of all these things. History says that the persons, those who were spending their life in lack of facilities, comfortabilities, those who were not convenient with their means and sources, they proved themselves at the top rank in the history. As the persons, those who were the starters, beginners, initiators in the field of science, religion, spirituality, arts, commerce, renowned artists, recognized traders, businessmen, they proved this thing that they were known by their actions and works. They were the strong believer of this slogan that work is worship. Work is worship or action is worship. But the true work, true action is the superb task of our human mind and human soul. For it, our free thinkers, freedom fighters, messengers, astronomers, astrologers, novelists, dramatists in the field of literature, history, we study that they establish their landmark and milestone. Words fall short in their praise. What helps in reappearing the form of God? But it is also right that where there is no word, there is also the presence of Lord or God. So this is the greatest notion of our freedom fighter, social reformist, Swami Vivekananda, who proved the whole universe that we are known not only by externalities, hypocrisies, superstitions, but we are known by the manners, talents, styles, standards that was regenerated, recreated and returned by our present Prime Minister in the whole world. The power of returning, Swami Vivekananda proved. Everyone who is sitting, who is appearing in any examination, who is preparing any competition, he or she must go through life after death and second edition of Swami Vivekananda, his work and its secret. If a competitor strives hard, struggles unexpectedly, undesiringly, then he can attain and obtain his real ultimate life, goal of ultimate life. These were the words that was addressed by Swami Vivekananda with his thoughts He starts his psychology of the words, also present today in every field of our science, religion, spirituality, arts, commerce and engineering. One idea, one nation, one man can change the whole scenario of the whole world of this materialistic consumptions. So spiritual life is the utmost and superb, matchless. We are to take promise daily that we are to think better, nicer, finer for our elders, ancestors, forefathers and for our futuristic generation. We should get the blessings and grace of God by